1764, Colonel Henry Bouquet marched a Royal American Regiment down the Ohio, from Fort Pitt to the forks of the Muskegon. Though it was every foot of 100 miles, with hostile Indians lurking behind each bush, the Colonel sent his 1,500 regulars stomping through the wilderness, making noise enough for 10,000. Delawares were so impressed, they sent their most important chiefs to palaver with him.
Nagacha Kuloga.
He's Kuloga, chief of the Delawares.
Hey yo, hey, hey yo, hey yo, Kayowani ho, Kayowani ho, hey yo, hey, hey yo, hey yo.
Kitani tuet, Lojun langun dogawan, Shakini luna langun shen, huska.
With this belt, I open your ears and your heart. The will of the Great Spirit that there should be peace between us.
You speak of peace, but murder our people on the frontiers.
Hiluna kimiyak soigan nihila lachik.
Wapsik tispat langoma konestogas wishitank lauchin mulangundin.
Our cousins, the Conestogas, believed the white man and took his religion.
Wapsit unchki pestank. Bahaikan, tamahaikan.
Then the white men from Peshtank came with guns and hatchets.
What does he mean by Peshtank? The men of Peshtank?
The Paxton boys.
Nekamawa. Mina chow soagan. Ink te hek me hook shawek. Uchka hook amebens.
They murdered in cold blood helpless Indian women and children.
Wapalesh and machtando. Maloken palaloga soagan.
The white barbarians scalped them and did indecencies.
The Paxton boys were cowards. They were afraid to fight the Indian warriors, so they killed the women and children in the dead of night. But I come to you in the broad daylight to speak with you face to face. And I tell you that no white man will settle on your lands beyond Fort Pitt. But I will give you another promise. Neither the Paxton boys nor the other hotheads on our frontiers will kill any Indian unless you attack them.
Peshtank medhik kichilakton. Wapsit ata go mekmari wiki nit ata Fort Pitt. Nihilo win nahema lagundo we.
Wapsikak lago. Nyochak.
Kabasu. Eli wapsit kadatan.
What promises does our white brother ask in return?
At every former treaty, you have promised not to murder our people. But you have promised to deliver up all your captives. Now, if you want war, you may have it. But if you want peace, you must deliver into my hands all the white prisoners in your possession.
What does the white warrior mean?
He says to bring him white sons and daughters, or the white men move on warpath.
Once you were white.
I am Indian. My father's Kuloga. He will never accept their terms.
Thank you.
Uski haki. Langon dui me he took. Pemout sohin, so gout sin, I just came.
We will put fresh earth to the roots of the tree of peace so that it may live and flourish while the sun shines and the rivers run.
I speak for my brother, Little Crane. He has married a white prisoner. Soon she will bear him a child.
It is wrong for the child of Little Crane to be brought up by the whites.
The white squaw must go.
She does not wish to go. Only those who wish to go should be given to the whites.
The council has voted. We will not break the treaty.
The white men will break it. White men always break treaty.
Bouquet will keep his word. Kologa will keep his word.
Not the bride of Little Crane adopted by the tribe?
She was adopted, true son, but all must go. Even you.
Am I not the son of Kologa?
You are my son.
Look into my heart. Is it white or Indian?
Your heart is Indian.
And I will never go back to the whites. They are my enemies.
My son must go. Then all Indians may live in peace. It is the law.
Nishketun has spoken to the council about the bride of Little Crane. If they vote against Kologa, you may stay too. But I do not think they will vote against the chief.
I will never go back to the white people.
You will obey Kologa. You will go, and I will go with you. On the march, we will kill all the white devils. Come back to the village as great warriors.
There are too many for us.
The more there are, the more scalps we can take.
If only we could. I'm sorry, my cousin. Where I'm going, you cannot follow. Do you remember what Sumakek did when his children deserted him?
He ate of the mandrake root until he was dead.
The white soldiers will never take me out of the forest alive. When I see the mandrake plant, I will fall to the ground. And when they pick me up, I will be dead. True son will lie there, silent and superior to the white man.
I will find your grave and bring word to your father, Kologa. He will come to you then.
He will say true son has triumphed over his enemies.
Nothing. Not a sign.
The day isn't over yet.
Colonel, I don't think they ever meant to bring him in. I lived among the Delawares myself when I was little, and I can tell you this. When a captive isn't killed, he's usually adopted. Mostly for a dead relative. They baptize you in the river to wash away your white meanness and to put brave Indian thoughts into your head. And when that's done, your flesh are their flesh and blood are their blood, and they're not going to let you go. Not ever. Sure wrong. Poor devils.
Il est en agon. Yoni, je ne come upon it on.
This boy is his own son. He says that now he belongs to you.
A Anneligi guila nape l'aniquis. A wulsit amen.
If you know what's good for you, you won't try to get away.
I spit on white people.
And don't forget you're white, too.
I'm Indian.
Well, your father and mother are white.
My father is Kaloga. My mother, Kakanga.
Well, lately, maybe. But you had another father and mother before them. The ones you got that curly hair and blue eyes from.
Nobody can help how he's born.
You can argue like an Indian, all right. Among the Indians a long time. You'll come to feel differently when we get back to Pennsylvania.
I will never go back to Pennsylvania.
Young fool, you're going back to Pennsylvania and you're going back alive.
She wait, I'll lose.
She gone.
His name is Half Arrow, true son's cousin. Said they came along to keep him company.
Maybe he's just what the doctor ordered.
Not eat, you will not have the strength to kill all these white soldiers and come back to the village with me.
When you speak of pleasant things, keep your voice low. The white men do not understand when we make happy talk.
Even if we take no scalps, you should eat, or you yourself will die.
Why should I live when my father forsakes me?
I bear a present for my cousin. I talk now for your mother, Kakwenga. Here are moccasins, so that you might go among the white people newly shod. I remember your mother who sent them.
Did my father send me nothing?
The father of true son sends him a bearskin so he might go warm at night and remember his father, Kaloga.
Will Half Hour wear this?
I will wear it to remember my cousin. When true son wears his bearskin, the white people will treat him with respect. Your father sent you a message. These are his words. Remember what happens to the white prisoners that the Indian takes. If he bears his hardship with patience, his Indian master likes him But if he fights back and complains, there's nothing else to do but to scalp him. Do not fight back. Live with patience and cheerfulness, and the white man will like you.
Tell my father I will remember. Tell him I will bear my disgrace like an Indian.
Now, will you eat?
I will eat.
Friends can go.
Why do you spit my cousin?
Well, only white captives can enter Fort Pitt. Colonel's orders.
He's not half ours, Colonel. Yeah.
I wasn't trying to shoot your friend. He tries to cross that river, somebody else might.
Yes, sir.
I hope I'm not late. My name's Butler, Harry Butler.
Yes, sir?
I've come to claim my boy.
John Butler.
I guess you hardly remember me. It's been so long. Why, you're a big fella now. Your mother won't know you. Welcome back, Johnny.
Saga. Saga.
Thank God you're safe.
Haven't you a word to say to your own father?
He is not my father.
Mr. Butler, he has been living with the Indians a long time. It's going to be hard at first getting used to each other. But I think after he's been home a while...
Yes. Yeah, we got to get him home. Come on, Johnny. I brought a spare horse for you.
Mr. Butler, would you mind if our scout Dale Hardy rides along with you? He has got an errand down that way.
Always glad to have company.
Would you mind waiting outside for a moment? How would you like to take a little leave, Dale?
Well, fine, sir. I haven't been home in a long time.
Well, I didn't exactly mean a full leave. I was thinking more in terms of a lighter duty. I thought you might ride along and be of service to Mr. Butler.
I thought I was shut of that young catamount. I guess it wouldn't help the treaty any if he were to scalp his white father and run back to Cologa.
I'm more afraid of what they might do to him.
Who?
The Paxton boys. The Butlers live in Paxton Township. And as long as young Butler thinks he's a chief son, he's powder by the fire.
Well, what do you want me to do about it? Spank him or whip them?
Use your own good judgment.
May I make a suggestion, sir? The commander of the Paxton boys is John Elder. Whatever the rest may be, he's a mighty fine man. If Dell were to make friends with him, the two of them might be able to persuade several of the Paxton boys to volunteer for service here at the fort.
Well, what good would that do?
It might do a lot of good. Just give them a chance to drill those hotheads and we will have no more trouble. It isn't the soldiers that start the wars. You bring me 100, Dell, or even 50.
Well, before they sign up, can I tell them what kind of leave they're going to get?
Look there. We're home, Johnny. Target practice. Myra.
Upstairs resting. She's all right. Me and the girl came over to red up a bit before you got here.
Mrs. Owens, this is Dell Hardy.
Nice to know you, ma'am.
She lives next door. And this is Johnny. You ought to recollect your Aunt Kate.
The Shenandoah. She's my servant girl. She's mortal afraid of Indians, and she got good cause. She's enough to frighten anyone. The sooner you get him out of that rig and get up, the sooner he'll start acting civilized.
Kate, thank you for helping Myra. Well, come on in. We're here, Myra.
Aren't you going to bring him up?
Be right there.
John. You look like an Indian, John. You even walk like one. Doesn't he remember any English?
When he wants to. Myra, this is Dell Hardy. He's come to see John Elder. I've talked him into staying with us while he's here.
You're most welcome, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
You've been away a long time, John. And your education has been arrested. Now you must realize that you're not an Indian. You never were. You're John Cameron Butler, and it's time you remembered it. Repeat it after me. John Cameron Butler. Say it. John. John.
Myra, don't tire yourself.
Very well, John. If you're going to be stubborn and willful, we will have to act accordingly. Your family and friends are coming to see you, and I won't have you standing up crude and ignorant as a savage in front of them. You will not leave this room until you speak your own name.
My name is Lenniqui.
In English, it means original son or true son.
He is not with the Delawares now. He is at home under our roof. And here he must recognize his name.
True son is my name. My mother and father gave this name to me.
I am your mother, Myra Butler. This is your father, Harry Butler. You are John Cameron Butler.
Lenniqui Butler.
John Butler.
John Butler.
Thank you, John. Here are some old clothes of your father's. See if they'll fit you.
Come along.
John, you're to take a bath before you change. If you don't, I'll wash and dress you myself.
Johnny, this is your room. Mr. Hardy, could you... you help with that bath while I do the chores? And you douse it in the water like this. Take the soap. Put it on like this. Then you scrub. I guess I'll have to call your mother after all.
White squaw give orders all the time?
Well, the whites do let their women folk have their say. And that's a fact. There are a lot of things like that you just have to get used to. Like taking a bath. You won't be swimming in the rivers and lakes, most like. So you'll just have to bathe or you'll stink.
Indian no stink. White man stink.
Well, I've smelled Indians when I thought the bear grease was pretty high. Still and all, when I get into a stuffy house with a whole room full of white people, I know what you mean. Once you start wearing clothes, you'll smell that way too. Unless you scrub.
Pleased to meet you, Parson Elder.
Colonel Bouquet wanted me to meet John Elder, but he didn't mention you were a preacher.
From what I know of your colonel, I think he's more interested in my rangers than in my pulpit.
Can I talk to you about that sometime?
Anytime, anytime at all.
I'm so sorry.
Millie, meet Mr. Hardy. This is my daughter, Millie.
Your servant, ma'am.
Oh, excuse me. Come on down, son.
Come on, son. Johnny, this is Parson Elder.
God's been very good to you, my son.
And your uncle, George Owens?
Yes, sir. You're a lucky boy. How many come back alive to tell the story?
You remember Millie. Millie Elder? Of course he does. I was with him the day he was captured. Remember, Johnny? We were building a playhouse of shag bark while the cradlers were cutting the wheat. I was hiding so the Indians didn't see me. Don't you remember? You've met Aunt Kate and Shenandoah, but not your Uncle Wilson.
Welcome back, Johnny. I guess you're glad to be out of the clutches of those devils. Well, aren't you? What's wrong with him, Myra? Turned Indian?
Johnny's no Indian. He has the same white blood as Kate and me.
I should hope so.
Johnny, this is Mr. and Mrs.
Lucy, I want you to behave.
Sarah's
when you came home yesterday, you said he looked like an Indian.
It's different with those clothes on. When his hair grows out, he's going to be the spitting image of his grandfather, Espy.
Okay, what he looks like. What he's like inside. Boy, can be born white, but those savages drill their red heathen notions into him mighty fast. Lying and stealing, the virtues, butchering and scalping, they like even better.
Kate, will you help me with the refreshments?
Watch what you say.
Johnny, that tribe you're with, how many white women and children do they scalp? I was speaking to you. I'm waiting for an answer.
You a dummy or what?
Kilo New York, Lenin Apica Che, Nihilo N, Wapso,
Akuyuk, Wakum, I'm a man.
What'd he say?
He says you're mistaken. Indians don't make war against the white squaw in the lodge or the papoose in the cradle.
Oh, they don't, eh? See this girl? She's Shenandoah Hastings. She was bound over to us by the orphans court in Carlisle. She indentured to my wife to learn the art and trade of housewifery. Didn't have anybody till we took her in. You want to know why? Because her mother and father were scalped by Indians on a farm not 20 miles from here. Tell them what they did to your little sister. They scalped her, didn't they?
Yes.
Are you chief of the Peshtak men?
It means, are you the leader of the Paxton boys? I think he's got in mind what they did to the Conestoga.
Oh, he has he? Well, I'm proud to say I'm one of the Paxton boys, like all the rest of those present. Although I don't claim I was on the raiding party that particular night, I think they did a first-rate job of cleaning out the vermin.
It's hardly the time to be talking about
it. He's right.
Wilsey's right.
Of course I'm right.
My father, Kaloga, told me men are cowards who fight children. But you kill the Conestoga children and blow off the heads of Indian women.
Well, they got what they deserve. Now, they won't be butchering any more of our people. The squaw won't be breeding any more murderers.
You butcher. You murder.
That's enough, Wilsey.
You lay a hand on that boy again, and you'll answer to me.
We don't like Indian lovers in this community.
I'm not talking about the community. I'm talking about me and you.
Keep your eye on your boy, Harry. Maybe real trouble. Come on, George.
That was a good lick. Now you drive in the wedge.
Shenandoah. Where Meyer put those Indian clothes that Johnny was wearing when he came home?
I think they're in his room.
Well, go fetch them here.
I wouldn't dare.
You got the run of the house. You and Kate do half of Meyer's work for her. Nobody will notice you.
I'd be afraid.
You better be afraid of disobedience. Now, don't give me any back talk or I'll sell your indenture.
I'll get them.
Shenandoah? Come here. Here's your pretty little thing.
Said I was to call.
Come in.
Maybe he's busy.
He isn't doing a thing.
Who is it, Millie?
It's Mr. Hardy, Father. I told him you weren't busy.
Oh, well, you're most welcome. Help me off.
Please, Father, I'm almost finished.
Sit down.
You don't mind, do you, Mr. Hardy?
Oh, no, ma'am.
Now, you see, Mr. Hardy doesn't mind. Mr. Hardy isn't the kind of man who wants to see a preacher in a pulpit looking like a shaggy old sheepdog. Unless what you have to say is private.
Oh, no, ma'am.
Well, even if it is, I won't listen.
How's the recruiting going along?
Well, I'm making no headway at all. Everybody hates the Indians, but nobody wants to join the army. I don't understand it.
You would if you knew the Scotch-Irish. Most of the settlers around here have ancestors who fought the British at Londonderry. All they have against Colonel Bouquet's Royal American Regiment is the word royal. And they're not a bad lot.
They don't seem the kind that would massacre peaceful Indians.
They aren't. But you give them a jorum of whiskey and they might kill anybody. Regret it most heartily afterwards. I know they're ashamed right now.
Wilsey Owens. Is he ashamed?
No. He's not Scotch-Irish. Of course, we don't really know who's responsible.
Everybody knows. There wouldn't have been any trouble except for Wilsey Owens and his brother George. My father won't say anything because they're members of our church.
Oh, Millie.
Well, sir, I don't want you to think I'm snooping, but I'm worried about the butler boy. He was a chief's son, and I've got to see him settled in here peaceably, or there might be trouble.
Well, maybe a sermon aimed at Wilsey Owens.
The golden rule. Do unto others as you would have others do unto you.
Possibly, or judge not that ye be not judged.
Maybe you could work it around so it'd mean if Wilsey doesn't leave that boy alone, somebody's going to invite him out behind the barn.
Well, that might do him a world of good. Well, I wish I could help you with your recruiting.
Target practice.
Yes, they'll all be there. We hold it every Wednesday afternoon.
You'll have to go to prayer meeting afterwards.
I admire to. Thank you, Reverend.
Not at all. See you this afternoon.
Oh, of course. Time for your reading lesson. You don't need to stand, John. Wouldn't you rather use the chair?
It is better to sit on the floor. Always I sit upon the ground outside. It is the lap of my mother, the earth.
What a lovely way to say it. Some of your Indian expressions are beautiful. Maybe if I help you improve your English, you can teach me Delaware.
I will teach you Lenni Lenape, and we will not need the English.
You should know both. You should learn all you can while you're young. Like the wood chopping, your father tells me you're learning to handle an axe very well indeed.
My father, Kaloga, told me that a tree has a soul, and it is wrong to kill a good friend.
Kaloga must be a fine man, son. I'm glad of that.
He told me to obey my white father. So I chop. But the Great Spirit will punish.
If Kaloga had thought it was wrong for you to learn the white man's way, he wouldn't have sent you to us.
He sent me so that all Indians could have peace.
Then you must show everyone that you're worthy of Kaloga's teaching. I guess we'll have to work a little harder on these lessons. And I'll read it through first, just four verses. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Here, Johnny. Start with this one.
Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
Always says God one way. Lenni Lenape say God many ways. Eliwulik, the one above everything. Eliwulisit, the one greatest in goodness. Always a new way.
Eliwulik, the one above all. Eliwulisit, greatest in goodness. Oh, that's lovely, John.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which...
What is it, Johnny?
How's that for a target? A real, genuine Redskin. Come on, boys, gather around. Parson Elder here says we're going to see some real tip-top quality shooting.
Yeah. We'd all like to see how a soldier of a king can shoot.
All right. Only let's don't use a straw Indian for a target. Let's shoot at his tomahawk.
Go ahead.
me now. Hey there! Hey!
Touches that target, he loses a hand.
You're out of turn. You told me to shoot first.
Satisfied, Wilson?
I ain't shot yet.
Care to risk the weather vane on your barn?
Guess prayer meeting didn't agree with you.
Oh, I like it fine, Miss Millie. I was thinking, that's all. Thought maybe you might help me with Johnny Butler.
Well, I'd be glad to if I can.
We're saving this for anyone.
For you. My father only likes it hot. Sit down. Now then?
Well, as I said before, I got to see Johnny settled in here peaceful-like, or I can't rightfully leave. The way Wilsey Owens is acting doesn't look very hopeful.
I heard you shot rings around Wilsey Owens.
Guess I was lucky.
Did you learn that in the Army?
No, I've always had a rifle in my hand.
And you always will?
Ma'am?
You plan to make the Army your career?
I never thought much about it. Might try farming if I found any reason to change. Well, that's Johnny's problem. Gotta find a reason strong enough for him to give up his Indian ways.
Well, there must be something.
What about a girl? Having a girl could make a big difference to any man.
Maybe you're right.
Trouble is going to be getting one. That's not exactly my line.
There are lots of nice girls in the community. He'll meet somebody and then they'll find something in common.
You mean I'm going to have to wait here till all that happens?
Sometimes you can help those things along. I could suggest to the butlers to give Johnny a dance and then he could meet some of the young people.
Sounds good.
It'll take me a little time to make the arrangements. Would you like to call again and talk them over with me?
You just say when.
Tomorrow night for supper.
Fine.
Anything special you'd like me to cook?
Apple pie?
I'm sorry about your clothes. I mended the bullet holes best I can.
Wait. Do not scream. Why did you lie?
What do you mean?
You said that Indian scalped your small sister.
They did. I saw it.
That is not true. I see many scalps, but no children's scalps in our village.
Maybe your tribe didn't, but the Wyandots did.
Maybe the Wyandots, not the Lenni Lenape. Did you steal my bearskin?
Yes. Uncle Wilsey made me. Elsie had sold me.
Sold you?
You see, I'm bound out to your Aunt Kate and Uncle Wilsey. It's like being a slave, only not forever. Next winter, when I'm 18, I'll be free.
The white man makes slaves of everything. The Indian is always free. I will never be a slave.
What are you going to do?
I wait. Someday a word bringer will come from my father, Kaloga. Always beautiful until the white man comes. Here even the water runs free.
I've dreamed about being free, like the deer, just wandering in the woods any way I please.
Shenandoah is worthy of being an Indian.
That shakes the barley.
Punch, Wilson.
No, thank you, no.
You try some of this for a change. Shenandoah.
Now you know what piece it's in.
Don't you worry. Musicians first.
Hope I get it.
Get what?
There's a favor in one of them pieces.
And a big piece for my Johnny.
Chew it up slow, you might break a tooth.
Give it to the one you like the most.
That's right, Johnny. It's an old custom. There's no harm in it.
You don't give it to a man. You give it to the girl you like best.
Now you gotta kiss her.
Indians do not kiss. Shenandoah.
Keep your snaky eyes off of her!
Ah! Johnny!
What happened? You tried to kill me.
I don't believe it. Johnny, come here. Johnny! Johnny!
Drunken fool.
What? Mr. Hardy.
Don't worry, ma'am. I'll find him.
Are you all right? I only want to help. So did Dell and Millie and your mother and father. We aren't all bad. It's just Uncle Wilsey.
If my father, Kologa, were here, he would go to Uncle Wilsey and say, my son does not know how to fight you with his fists, but he will fight you with knives.
That wouldn't do any good. It'd just make matters worse. You'd be a lot smarter if you just kept out of his way, like I have to.
I will kill Uncle Wilsey.
Killing just leads to more killing. Look, you just keep out of his way and he'll simmer down. And when you do see him, don't swell up like a rattlesnake and let him see just how much you hate him.
I will hate Uncle Wilsey.
It's hating on both sides that starts all the trouble.
I will always hate Uncle Wilsey.
Well, I hope you don't grow up to be like him. He's the biggest hater anywhere around.
Thank you.
the whole thing up, didn't she? Parson Elder couldn't have said it better himself. It's kind of hard to hate anybody up here. It's so peaceful. Shall we go back now? Millie, how do you go about claiming land in these parts?
Well, you can have 400 acres 1 year and an adjoining 1,000 the next just by building a cabin or raising one crop. Even tomahawk law is still legal. Deaden a few trees around the spring and you carve your name on the tree trunk. And the courthouse at Carlisle will recognize it.
Sounds easy.
Oh, it is. And there's lots of land left. There's a lovely site for a farm not 5 miles above the Mayhogs, with a stream running through it. And a hill just begging for a house.
Did anyone claim Piney Woods Mountain?
Oh, no, you wouldn't want that. Nothing but trees and rocks and topsoil so thin it wouldn't grow briars.
I think Johnny would like to have it. I thought of it tonight when I saw him up there. That forest was just made for him. I know. I lived with Indians, too, when I was a boy. Ran free in the woods. There's a glory around me then I haven't known since.
Now, I don't suppose you could live like other people. Either of you.
I'm not saying I couldn't. I promised a bouquet will fall. After that, I don't know. There's a girl I got my eye on. Trouble is, I don't know how to go about telling her. I guess I'll be pulling out in the morning. Might as well say my goodbyes now. Finer hospitality.
Couldn't you stay longer, Dell?
I wish I could, but I'm under orders.
When you say goodbye to Johnny, tell him about Piney Woods Mountain.
I will. And don't you worry. He'll like it.
We're afraid he'll like it too well.
Well, you can't make a plow horse out of a wild colt. But if you make friends with him, he'll come looking over your fence.
We'll be patient.
Bye, ma'am.
Good luck, Dell.
I had a talk with your folks. They're going to claim Piney Woods Mountain for you. How'd you like to have that for a holding?
The Hill of the High Spring?
Your dad's going to take you to Carlisle Courthouse to claim the mountain legal as soon as the hand's done. I think if you'll help your folks this summer, they'll let you build a cabin there this fall.
If you would stay, we could hunt together like brothers.
When I come back, we'll do that. Thanks.
Did you get the papers?
My white father's keeping them safe for me.
Then Piney Woods Mountain will be yours forever.
Yes. And soon I will build my lodge.
Oh, I wish I could help you with it. But I probably won't be here then.
Where are you going?
I don't know. But I've got to get away from Uncle Wilsey the minute my term is out.
My white mother needs help. Work for her.
I thought of that. Or I might get married.
Who will you marry?
I don't know. But I'm to get a new dress, along with my freedom dues. And that's the law. And maybe then I'll be pretty enough and somebody will notice me.
You're pretty enough now.
Oh, maybe for a servant girl, but not for a wife.
For a wife, too.
I hope the man I marry will think so.
I do not want you to marry anybody else.
Oh, Johnny.
Stay here. I will come back.
Guard! Guard, get down!
Lena PKW.
Lena, how did you come?
Just got out.
Pepper. What are you doing here?
Little Crane and I were trying to find you. As we were crossing this grazing land, the white man fired at us.
Where's Little Crane?
Come, I will take you to her. He came to visit his white squaw. A trapper told him he was now a papa. When we could not find her, we asked for you at the trading post. Surely we thought Truson will know where she lives.
What did you do to make the white man shoot at you?
I do not know. When we came upon them suddenly in the dark, they pointed their guns at us. And though we ran like the deer, bullets sped faster.
Stay where you are. You're in on this.
Wilsey Owens!
Over here!
It's Johnny!
And now, we'll take his scalp.
No!
Johnny!
It's Uncle Wilsey. He tried to kill us. Come, we will go to my people. We will be happy there.
Your people are here. You have your rights. We'll fight for them.
Wilsey Owens!
Ulachi!
We must go now, or they will kill us.
Please. Please, Johnny, listen to me.
Wilsey! Wilsey Owens!
Johnny!
To starve. Never have I seen such a fish.
I did not want my cousin to be like the white man, kill more than he can eat.
Tell me more about the white people. Did you ever get to understand them?
Well, sometimes I thought I did. I thought I would try to be a white man, too. But then they would act so queer. Well, they'd crowd around close and stare at me as if they were nearsighted. And they always talked loud, as if they were hard of hearing. And all at once, it's like waterfowl.
My father said that the Great Spirit made us from the beginning. But the whites, they're new people, mixed and of all colors.
Like horses.
Like the Colonel's horse.
Some even have red hair like a horse's blanket.
And some the color of a rotten log.
They smell like rotten logs. Now I will not stink.
Look, look, the shoe floats. Look.
Thanks! Ah! Ay, 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 ay.
Now you are Indian again. Last night I was not sure. If we had taken your white uncle's scalp, we would be great warriors. But I do not think you wanted a white girl to see. They say that a fish can swim from here to the forks of the Muskingum. Do you want to go?
I will go.
Are you lonesome for Shenandoah?
When I think of Shenandoah, I will remember Little Crane.
All right, you'll get your supper.
Look what the Father of Heaven has provided for us. Canoes.
But they belong to the trader.
Cousin, you have lived among the whites too long. What have they not taken from us? Look at the white trader's fine house. Think of how much he must have stolen from the poor Indians who trade with him.
He is half Indian himself, I think.
Then we will take only half of his canoes. We will take the larger one, for there is only one of him. But there are two of us.
Float down the river anymore? Come on, inside. Here.
Did the trader see you?
No, he was a white man. If he had been half Indian, he would have listened to his dog. Sorry I left in the larger canoe.
Why was my cousin so generous?
The big one had an iron rope. Do not speak to the squaws and children. We are hunters now.
Where is my brother, Little Crane?
The brother of Neskatoon was murdered by the whites.
Why is True Son not living with the white people?
I could not.
Come.
It cries for blood.
Yay!
It is high in the sight of heaven.
Yay!
Look this way. Who will join me on the warpath?
Yay!
Who will avenge the death of my brother, Little Crane?
Would Neskatoon destroy our nation to avenge his brother?
I do not ask for all to go. I need only a small war party. 20 scalps would give my brother rest.
The small flame kindles the great fire.
Neskatoon did not start it. The men of Peshtank killed my brother, and Bouquet did not stop them.
Maybe he does not know.
Does he not know that white settlers build cabins on Indian lands? Promises of Bouquet are like smoke.
We will send him a message. I myself will deliver it.
This is the only message the white men understand.
Come. The council will decide between us.
What if it votes with me?
Then I will obey the council. I will help you get your 20 scalps.
Calogria's chief. Will he direct the band?
He who proposes the raid is the leader. Kaloga will obey the commands of Nishkitu.
Kaloga will take half the warriors and go north to search for white settlers. The rest will follow me south. We will meet here in the morning.
Good morning, Dale.
Good morning, sir.
Well, your time is just about up. How would you like to re-enlist under a general?
A general? Congratulations, sir.
I know I can get you a captaincy.
Well, I'd like that fine. But when I was down in Paxton, I'd almost decided to get some land and try farming.
I see.
Yes, sir. If there were a war going on, well, that'd be different. But when there's not a shadow of trouble in sight.
I think I understand. Is she pretty?
Yes, sir.
Congratulations, Dale.
Thank you, sir.
Now, before you go, will you help me keep a promise I made the Indians?
Yes, sir.
We've got to stop those settlers taking up land on the Indian side of the Ohio. They've been sneaking their boats past us in the night.
Well, how shall I go about it?
Take some men downstream. If you find any settlers in forbidden territory, march them right back out again.
How much further?
The river winds. We haven't gone 30 miles yet. There's our settlers.
Scalps.
Nishkitun has done well. For our part, we saw no settlers.
Huh. Look what we have done.
Yukala! Oh, that I had been the lucky one.
Are the children of the whites our enemies also?
They are enemies, yes. Was little Crane young or old? Bishi. He was only a youth, and yet he was murdered by your white uncle.
I ask you to forgive my ignorance. I did not know we fought children.
Young cousin, I do not fight children. But on the war path, it is easier to carry a scalp than a prisoner.
Nichi, Wapsit, Mahul.
Now your son will be good for something. Dress yourself in those. You can call your white cousins into shore. When the boat comes close, we will fall on them with lead and hatchet. Remember, you are not Lenape. Now you are white. You must talk and act white. We must make their foolish hearts bleed so they will come close to help you.
Brothers! Help! Brothers! I'm English! I have white skin, like you! Take me with you! Take me or I'd starve!
If he's white, why does he say brothers like the savages do?
Maybe he escaped from the Indians.
If you're white, wait out to the middle and I'll pick you up.
It's deep! I cannot swim!
I wouldn't come any closer if he had a Bible in his hand.
Give me that pole.
Push in.
Against settling in this valley?
Well, who says we can't? The king?
The king? I'm talking about General Bouquet himself.
We ain't in the army.
Neither were those 15 settlers we buried this morning. Indian scalped every last one of them. Don't I know you?
You should. I marched with you and Bouquet to the forks of the Muskingum and back. Seen that bottom land, maybe we want to settle here.
Have you considered that women, folk, and children are worth more than corn?
Yeah. All right, boys. Let's turn back.
Hey, I know that boy the Indians used to decoy us. Seeing you made me remember. He was that chief's son that you had to keep tied up so he wouldn't kill himself.
True son?
Yeah, that's what you called him. He was the one that warned us off. Must have been some white in him after all.
True son is a true son no longer. His heart is that of a serpent. His tongue is like the crooked stripes on the white man's talking papers. There is no Indian blood in him.
Thank you.
Brothers, I have listened to the council. I hear that my son is a spy from the whites, that his tongue is like the fork of a tree. Brothers, I know my son. He's like Kuloga. If he is double-tongued, then Kuloga's to blame. Why don't you bind and burn Kuloga? Kuloga's responsible. Kuloga gave him all his instruction. What do you expect of me? Just to stand idly by while you burn my son? Little Crane has been avenged. 15 scalps have given his spirit rest. Now there will be no more fighting, unless you fight me.
This is where we part. My place is on this side. Your place is on that.
My father, are we to say goodbye to each other now?
Enemies do not do so. I am no longer your father, nor are you my son. But sometime we meet in battle, you must kill me. For that is what I must do to you.
See you. Last thing I heard, you were taking up land. That's what I'm going to do. Go back and try farming. Maybe you'd like to join me.
I can't go.
What do you want me to tell your people?
I have no people.
Don't you want me to tell Shenandoah you love her?
She knows that.
Guess maybe you're right. The sooner she can forget you, the sooner she can find somebody else that's not afraid to protect her from Uncle Wilsey.
I will kill Uncle Wilsey.
Come on. Time you did a little thinking if you're going to go on living in this world. You had a good white father and white mother. You found a girl just made for you. Along come Wilsey. On the other hand, you're making out all right with a good Indian father and Indian mother. Then along come Niskatoon. That'll be enough to show you there's good and bad on both sides. So what can we do about it?
I will kill Uncle Wilsey.
No, you can't quite do that. This time you leave it to me. I'll take care of Uncle Wilsey.
Jerusalem. Look who's coming.
are you doing back here?
I want to be a white man now.
You're Injun through and through.
We're going to settle out right now. He's a white man. He proved it when he saved a boatload of white people from ambush. But his tribe scalped 15 settlers down the Ohio. What's your doing?
My doing?
They did it because you killed an Indian lad whose only crime was trying to visit this boy.
Them Indians attacked me.
You're a liar.
Little Crane was my friend. Wilsey is my enemy.
Now, wait a minute. You don't know the first thing about fist fighting. He'll kill you.
I will fight.
All right. Let's find out whether you're an Indian or a white man.
Take your time, Wilson. You ain't in a hurry. Bring the next one up square.
Chitlin', wasn't it? Plain as a chitlin'.
What is it, Myra?
Johnny's back.
Johnny?
He's fighting Wilsey in the pasture. You've got to stop them.
Dale!
Wait.
Get up, Johnny. Fight him. Fight him, Johnny. Fight him. Fight him.
Tell Johnny to dodge. Tell him an Indian.
Any quiz? Blow in, Wapsit.
Tell him not to hit him until you give the signal.
Kachin Nahila up. Nutumalan for Kulin Ted Sloan.
Let him throw away the rule book. I can fight and kick and gouge you the best of them.
Sorry, Wilsey. Stand back. Give me room to referee this fight.
Watch out, Finn. Hook on. Hook it. Hook it. Fuck. Okay, here we are.
That's the way, Johnny. That's the way.
Come on, Wilsey. Get him.
Hit him!
Give him another one.
Hit him!
Now one for me!
Had enough, Wilsey?
Go ahead and shake.
You white, all right.
All right, now you come.
Fight's over! Prayer meeting, 7 o'clock.
The whisper of leaves, the song.
song of a crow will keep you from feeling alone. Wherever you go, the forest will grow. You're safe in the place of your